Hey guys, Broker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Atletico Madrid career. Where last time I left off, I picked up, went in the league. Over. Alright. Las Palmas and...
Warm welcome to you from myself, Martin Tyler, and of course from Alan Smith alongside me as well. But warm actually isn't the word, really. Not here in the stadium.
I forget who the team was.
It's a bit chilly. Don't want to keep...
Espanol.
The snow for the moment doesn't seem
I remember. Espanol. It was Espanol and Las Palmas.
In this game today, they play Atletico Madrid.
Well, first versus fourth today, and the lead is thoroughly deserving of that position. And I think the fourth place team.
You're going to see a good bit of
the manager's disposal.
Villarreal. And I think we'll be because I'm both games things to come in this episode are against season. I have them today in the league. This is the last game before the January transfer window. Literally, this is on December 31st, so the window opens tomorrow.
The main striker today.
And start looking at possible signings and stuff like that, or possible departures. We'll see what happens.
Hit on the break.
And a few days into January, and like the 5th or 6th, I play Villarreal again in the first leg of our tie in the Copa del Rey. So, what are the odds? What are the actual odds?
Came in with a challenge, and the ball broke free. And it's out for a throw for Atletico Madrid.
Hey, a doubleheader against Villarreal.
Okay.
I'm not going to say no to that because, I mean, I have to play.
Griezmann.
Four times.
Threat from Atletico Madrid in these positions.
Of course, the Copa del Rey tie is two legs. And
it's going to be a goal.
Of course, I will be playing them later.
Just wondering about the effect of the snow into the player's eyes and seeing as clearly as they would do if there was no snow.
Well, that's the thing, isn't it? If it impairs vision and if it gathers on the ball as well, of course, that's when the ref has to have a look at it.
I'm sounding like this is the cup tie. This is not. This is the league, which is why green. And completely forgot to do what I would, said I would do.
Lead the league in that respect. Well, they've been full of goals and coming from all areas of the pitch too.
If you missed the last episode, I decided that I'm going to make a change in my
some potential in this move
just to try it out, and I completely forgot.
And Atletico Madrid get given a corner here.
You have to realize this is actually being recorded on Sunday morning. Not Saturday with the other two episodes. So this is going to be recorded just before I.
He's got his shot off.
Then I will record my Uncharted video.
Here's a chance to attack.
Chances are I'm going to die a few more times because, you know, I'm awful at the game, apparently. I mean. I'm trying not to hate the game because I am playing it for the first time. So
he's away.
Maybe it was just me
crosses in.
Being bad at it.
To put them in front. He just got the knack, hasn't he?
And say I have a habit of doing that, but I don't think I do. I mean, they say I did that with Mass Effect 2.
That's good balance from the striker. Not such from the goalkeeper.
Seemed to be distracted by the conditions.
I did.
The effect the snow was having on the ball there.
It was just awful. Like, the enemies were completely overpowered. I mean, it's kind of like the same situation. You stick your head out of cover to fire. and suddenly your health is
open the scoring 1-0 here.
They're gone. And I mean,
Victor Ruiz.
Whereas in Mass Effect 1, I had no such issues.
Crisp defending there.
So
now it goes into the wider area.
I don't know what they changed.
Good forward play from them.
Two. Penalty.
A penalty. But, well, well, well.
Yeah,
Did you see anything similar?
Anyway, a nice penalty here. Thank you, Gatan, for winning
that. No question, it was a foul.
Man, fucking kicked him in the back of the leg. he's acting surprised. I mean, you have no one to blame but yourself, mate.
Great penalty.
And he makes it 2-0. Go from the penalty spot. Oh, we're half an hour gone. Yeah. 2-0.
Well, he's done the job.
Yeah, I think some people are cut out for it. Some aren't. This lad certainly
in the first half. But, maybe I'll give Mass Effect 2 another chance. I don't think I'll do a playthrough on it. I think I might just play it for a leisure. I think I'm going to stick with, has four
games. To stretch the opposition using the wider areas. And the opposition will get
which brings me to Mass Effect Andromeda.
And they couldn't find the player that they were.
Has been released recently.
Jonathan Dos
I've
Santos.
Heard some people say it's good, some people well, say, hit, you know, it's ball. It's whatever, you know. It's down to personal opinion. I was kind of hoping they would release like a trial version of it so I can like see how I feel about the game, but they didn't.
The hat trick. It's a day he'll never forget.
So, the reason I wanted a trial version was like so I could see if I like the game before I get it.
Happens. You know, very rare, really.
I've gotten games
special goal.
And
yeah,
not
really gets the crowd buzzing. And looks like being this lad's day. Wonderful strike.
I got a UFC 2, and no matter what I do, I keep getting knocked out. So
well, they've widened the margin now.
I went all the badass fires in real life, and I keep getting knocked out.
Well, no shots at all so far for Villarreal.
Well, nobody has taken the responsibility here. I think they've just all lost the courage, shrinking into the shells.
I won one fight. I won one fight, and it was a training fight with my created fire. I was like, oh, maybe I'm good at this game. Because I had played UFC 2010. Undisputed 2010. For those of you.
Could be dangerous.
I mean, UFC fans will know that's actually the one with Brock Lesnar on the front cover.
And that's the referee signaling for halftime, blowing his whistle, and it's 3-0 here at halftime. Not sure what you think, Alan, but the team that's losing here,
and anyone who knows,
oh, they've been a disgrace really to their manager,
me,
to themselves, and to their
that's
team.
How I got into UFC. When Brock Lesnar started kicking ass in there, because of course I'm
really was a very one-sided first half, and the team on the wrong end of that scoreline has got to show a bit of backbone now.
I think I've told this story before. Maybe I haven't.
Good position. They've worked this attack
maybe
very
I haven't.
Well.
In case I
dangerous position now.
If I have, then those who've heard it before can turn away. But here's like a short version for those who might be new and haven't heard the story. Basically, I'm a wrestling fan, of course.
Here's a chance. Oh, that's a fantastic goal.
I'm in school one day, and a guy in my class who knew I was a wrestling fan, he was a UFC fan. So he comes in and says, "Hey, you're a wrestling fan, right?"
Atletico Madrid.
Yeah.
The goal scorers made the most of that corner because it was just a standard floated ball into the box.
He was, yeah, he was badass. So he tells me that Brock Lesnar is in a championship fight on Saturday. I'm like, confused, because I was like, Brock Lesnar vanished from the face of the earth after he lost to Goldberg at WrestleMania 20. But,
Victor Ruiz.
He reappeared. I didn't understand what he was telling me about. At first, I was like,
well, the home team has been outplayed, and the home supporters have lost their will to support, I think.
Pretty much, like, boxing, but,
seen one or two heading for the exit.
More to it. I said, well, I don't like boxing.
This could be it. Coming up.
He explained more of it and said,
well,
hey.
The winner of the Golden Boots in Euro 2016, a real breakthrough.
It's like a more extreme version.
I must say, he's playing up to those.
I don't know why he was using boxing
so far
as a comparison. Because the sports are nothing like.
Already, he's got himself some goals.
Boxing, they wear gloves, big poofy gloves, and like
having made that save.
The UFC fighters, they do wear gloves, but you know, not something that like limits their punching power.
A rare little bout of applause for him.
I in the fights I've seen, you see some dude get.
It's the Spanish Cup fixture.
God, by a fuck.
They'll be facing Atletico Madrid away.
You're like, holy shit! How is this
about cup football? And this one should not be.
It's insane. But yeah, the gloves in the UFC are completely different. I mean.
A look at the way Atletico Madrid are knocking.
It looked like you know, regular fingerless gloves.
At the moment, without any doubt, the way that they're passing the ball about,
they fit
the taking the chances.
Sport of US.
Can't do much more.
Totally odd. No. So I watched that Brock Lesnar fight.
Mario Gaspar.
He was facing some guy I'd never heard of, Randy Couture.
Atletico Madrid's so next game, Alan.
No, let me look up this Randy Couture
in the Spanish Cup.
Don't learn having too many about problems. So I was like, wow,
but he's been stopped.
This is gonna be interesting. Does Randy Couture?
He's going to be a substitution here for the home side.
And then Brock Lesnar just decimated him. I was like, wow.
And in goes the cross.
I mean, I knew Brock Lesnar looked like he could kick anyone's ass, legit.
It blocked it then.
Because, of course, in professional wrestling,
could have been a corner.
You know, it's all staged.
Veered away, it'll be a throw.
Some people say fake.
And this will be two changes.
Scripted.
At one go for the manager.
Same. It is kind of.
Atletico Madrid in these positions.
It doesn't matter.
He's got his shot off.
Because almost everything is fake. But UFC, there's nothing fake about that.
And it's out now for a goal kick. We should thank these supporters, Alan, for the atmosphere they've created for us to work with today.
Unreal kind of stuff that happened with us.
Yeah, and quite rightly, they're celebrating that here. They can afford
and,
to relax.
And, you know, seeing that got me hooked. Well, and even after Brock Lesnar went away, I still watch UFC today. I was caught by a well-known Irish fighter by the name of Conor McGregor.
That looked very good indeed, but the move has broken down. That looked dangerous until he made the interception.
So, UFC caught my attention from the very beginning. That's in a nutshell. Well, that's pretty much the whole thing. Any UFC fans, like, they
goes for it with a fist. And shoots.
Brock Lesnar. Now, WWE fans could probably tell you what happened. And because WWE, anytime they mention Brock Lesnar to us, the accomplishment, they say, oh, he beat Randy.
They never let up, did they? They
or kept on going for the world title.
A very big margin of victory.
That over and over again, it's so annoying. You know, like, those who know, and those who don't know, either don't care or don't want to know.
La Liga, Villarreal 0.
I mean, even those who
four
have heard WWE talk about UFC.
At the top of the table remain.
Some people don't watch
Madrid with 48 points.
It'd be like
in second, Valencia with 20.
Who the hell is Rang Tour? When did this happen?
Barcelona with 28 points. In fourth, Villarreal.
Not everyone watches it.
In fifth, Real Madrid with 27 points, but only behind on goal difference. In sixth, Ibar with 25 points. In eighth,
it could get very annoying. I know, friend
with 9 points.
Does know.
And then reading up the table, second bottom, Real
Betis. He's watched a few points,
but only behind on goal difference.
He normally only watches Conor fight with 12 Conor McGregor.
Fourth bottom, Athletic Bilbao.
He says every time he hears WWE hype up Brock Lesnar's accomplishments in the UFC, he wants to put a hole through a telly. I can only imagine what would happen if he met Michael Cole in real life. Michael Cole and JBL, they're both really guilty of doing that. They constantly do it. It's really annoying. To say the very least, it is really annoying. And I mean, JBL would have to worry about fans wanting his head for other reasons and stupid remarks, but his constant annoying commentary is another problem. I'm gonna go with this. Gabby and Thiago. Get Thomas out for go with Moreno on the bench. Or on the pitch rather, as Verdo on the field. Jimenez. Oh, Hendricks is back to full fitness, and yeah, he can play in this match. It's good. He was recently injured last month for a few weeks, and luckily he is back now in time to play against Villarreal again. Didn't we just play these guys? I feel like we did. I don't know why I get the feeling. How convenient, if you ask me.
This stage, with 16 teams left in the Spanish Cup, it's beginning to
going
be
to this more of a game. Event. The nice big victory
I think the players will have felt that in the warm-up, and certainly now, just before kick-off, they'll be buzzing.
The Atletico Madrid lineup: Andre Moreira, the goalkeeper. Thiago plays with Gabby in the centre of the park.
Early goal. Ooh, Victor Ruiz, he almost put it into his own net.
This is the lineup for Villarreal. Jonathan Dos Santos starts, a player struggling for four. So a couple of strikers for them at the front end of the team. Good pass, getting it forward. The shot's on!
Thiago.
Punched away by the goalkeeper.
Oh! Sure! Those were glory! By
some distance in the end.
It was never going in, was it? I like that he put out the exact same squad I changed.
Jonathan Dos Santos. A couple of teammates who are clearly on the same wavelength. This could be a chance. He's going to try his luck. Oh, great work by the keeper.
Ah. Come on, get the ball. Pressing X, tackle him for interception. Fuck's sake.
Oh, could be it.
Yes. Go on, Gabby.
And in the shotgun.
Slow it home. Hit the post. Are you freaking kidding me?
Excellent interception. Now he's looking for support.
Hendricks.
Here comes the cross.
Reno.
Well,
yes, or does not get brings. It away. He's in the corner. Hendricks will break back.
Onto the attack now. What a save!
That's not what I told you to do. I pressed the pass button, thinking he would cut back into the box and set out a player for someone.
Should have done better than to hit the post there.
To say thank you very much, eat the dick, and 1-0. No, he kicked it. He takes a shot for some reason. You know, I did not press circle, I pressed X.
Little headed pass then, and a shrewd one. Just working away to try and find an opening. Got past him. That will end the threat, at least for the moment.
Hendricks. Awa takes to the young Uruguayan dude.
And in goes the cross.
Whips it in. Fiatu! Get in. There we go.
A wonderful one.
Get straight.
Defenders seem to lose the concentration almost. They saw it coming from a long way.
Get back into the game.
Well, he's a fantastic header of the ball.
See if I can't make a quick fire double.
No shots at all so far for Villarreal.
Well, you get the feeling we could be here till midnight. We still wouldn't see a shot.
I don't know if this is a testament to the.
Preston won the ball well forward. Kevin Gamero!
Of...
It's in!
Final I was going to say.
They've got a firmer grip on the game now. They're two ahead. Well, it's a super.
I wasn't sure if the second team had quite the firing power. Is their money. That's a goal
well worth analyzing.
They weren't really causing Villarreal the same problems as well. Griezmann picked them apart. But, just as I was about to say, I can't remember what it was.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
After that first goal, so.
Mateo Pablo Mazzacchio. Space for the shot! Kevin Gamero! Good stop here.
For the record, Vieto will not be going back out.
Atletico Madrid.
Player. He's really improved from the first few games. He's impressed me enough too.
And it's a header. Well, that's great work by the goalkeeper.
He's going to stick around for the rest of the season. As,
Real opening now.
Romero.
Romero. Pushed onto the frame of the goal.
Oh my God. How did that lead to nothing?
Another turnover in play here with that interception. And the decision for the added time is 3 minutes.
Come on, header of that.
Atletico Madrid now.
Romero.
Great chance. Well, they got away with it in the end.
Leave the ball. Run without the ball. No. It's good when your team, when a teammate has the ball, but when you have the ball, and then you decide, oh, fuck it, I'm gonna leave the ball to itself, and I'm gonna fuck off. Yeah, that's top quality.
In the Spanish Cup, there's a lot of good action in the
earlier
rounds. Some of it here in the round of 16, and the second half of this tie has started.
Yeah, it's been a good match. The first half was entertaining, and more of the same, hopefully.
Oh my God, why did you both go for that? Ball, for fuck's sake, Romero! And you hit the bar. I won. You better fucking score. Soon as you get the ball again, Romero. Because you fucked up there. I was not even controlling Romero. I don't know why he was going for the ball. I was passing it to the dude who was running into the box. I'm not sure. I think it might have been Gabby. He was running into the box. He was gonna get a shot away and go, but fucking Romero comes back and he fucking pretty much tackles.
It's for the away team.
Was your man as he's about to take the fucking shot? And Romero then hits the fucking bar.
Well, that looked promising.
So that was a massive fuck up from Romero. I have no idea why he again had him run back and. He tackled his own player. He tackled his own teammate. You stupid idiot. How do you make that mistake?
It'll be a throw.
If your teammate is going to get a shot away and go,
whether the manager
let him
is
take the fucking
just
going to
switch things around
don't
a little bit.
Tackle him. Don't be. Be that guy. Don't be fucking Cristiano Ronaldo. Oh, I have to score everything. I have to be even in me. He's threat of this team. No one else can do anything for this team. No. There's no I in team. You fucking moron.
On EA Sports, coming up for you.
Very stupid decision.
They'll be hosting Barcelona.
Very stupid.
Yeah, that should be a good clash. I can't see too much to split between them.
Looked very good indeed, but the move has broken down. Tackle here. Thiago! Good try. It was the post.
Oh! So close again! Every time I feel like I'm going to score her goal. There's more goals in this game if I go for them.
Just a quick check on the clock.
That's
and
now
20 minutes to
Thiago
go.
Who has hit the post. Gabby has hit the post. Two of them have hit the post.
Good defending.
Unreal.
Kevin Gamero.
And I might be 3-0 up if fucking Romero was a complete fucking moron.
Kevin Gamero!
And he missed. That's it. He's fucking off. That was the last straw. And make some more changes. Bring a few players. Actually, I should put Correa out on the left.
Oh no!
But Guerrero, get the fuck off the pitch while you still have a fucking right to put on that shirt.
Couldn't finish it.
You pissed me off in this game.
They're going to make the change now. And I think he's happy to come off. He's
acting like a complete asshole.
Today. It's been a good all-round performance.
Yeah, interfering with.
He'll just be hoping now that his team can see out this match and win it.
Vieto. He wants to play on the shoulder.
And
of the
then
defender.
You miss a sitter. Right. I mean, if I want a player who's going to miss sitters, I'll recall Fernando Torres. Fucking idiot.
Vieto. There's some potential in this move. Opportunity now. He's kept it out. That's a corner for Atletico Madrid.
I missed a few opportunities, and a lot of those opportunities came to Guerrero. So the fact I'm gonna have to play the second leg, and I'm putting it down to Guerrero. I am. I don't care what.
He's had a go here. Shot blocked here.
You say
down now to the last.
He completely fucked up. And no, his goal did not redeem at all.
Goes in.
Because he got the goal, and then he turned into a fucking moron. As if his goal suddenly removed his brain.
Yes, it's a goal from the substitute, and he's quickly made his mark on proceedings here.
Come on.
Well, they've widened the margin.
See if we can't repair this damage. Probably too late. If you get one more goal, I might be in a safe position. Four is normal.
Teo Pablo Musacchio. To be added on here is a minimum of 3 minutes. Here's a chance to attack. Vince Strongly. He's been waving these shots goodbye, the goalkeeper. And there's another one.
Well, the defence in front of him, Martin, has been totally dominant, and as a result... Well,
Thiago. Yes, Vieto, you're clean through there, mate. Hey, go. Vieto.
Now the shot.
Yes.
It's the goal.
Get the ball. Get the ball.
I didn't see it as being...
If we're quick, we might have time. If we're quick, we might have time again. Nope. There are three sides. It happened.
Some celebrations at the final whistle.
Ooh, it's a tough one. It is a tough one.
Yeah, I mean, reasons to be pleased, but the manager in the dressing room now just needs to calm them down and concentrate their minds for this second leg coming up.
It was absolutely... extraordinary, exceptional, elegant, excellent.
Well, so often we...
Copa de...
Yeah. Spanish.
Well, we know it's the Copa del Rey.
Villarreal, nil. Celta de Vigo, 1.
Oh!
Malaga, 2. Deportivo La Coruña, 1.
Okay, Correa absolutely not. Reject all future offers. Huh. The second leg is the next game. I have a decision to make. And you will see what that decision... Why I decide in the next episode. Until then, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And I'll tell you all a very, very nice day. Peace.